Abiodun Faleke. I represent Ikeja Federal Constituency. I'm from Lagos. Mr. Speaker, let me thank you for yielding the floor to me at this time, and also thank the mover of this motion for coming up with this very, very critical motion at this material time. Mr. Speaker, honorable colleagues, we have read in the media, social media, electronic media, we've heard from electronic media on this, on this drastic situation unilaterally taken by the Minister of Labor and Employment. Mr. Speaker, my worry is the Minister of Labor and Employment, who is supposed to mediate between employees and employers, is single-handedly taking decisions without recourse to procedures. The government, Mr. President, was elected because of his pedigree. He was elected because of his promises. He was elected because they believe he would deliver. Unfortunately, Mr. Speaker, Mr. President on his own cannot directly deliver the goodies he had to appoint some ministers or some aides. We have seen in recent times, Mr. Speaker, how these ministers have abused their offices. And in this particular case, Mr. Speaker, the question that will come to our mind is, why will the Minister of Labour and Employment carry out this draconian decision without following the process? One, Mr. Speaker, there is a need for this House to look at appointment of board chairmen. It says the President shall appoint, but in practice, Mr. Speaker, the ministers nominate the board chairman, and if they not have the control of that board chairman, that's exactly the issue that you raised, which I think Mr. Honorable Abiodun did not respond to, that you read in the media, which we also read, that the President, or through the SGF, had approved. The issue was this. The agency has a board. If there's a disciplinary action required, the resolution of the board must go to the minister, from the minister to the SGF before a decision is taken. Even when the resolution of the board comes, the minister has no power to issue such letter. It is only the SGF that has the power, having taken decisions, instructions from Mr. President. Mr. Speaker, the Honourable Minister of Labour has abused his office. And if I were the President, I would get him removed immediately based on facts. The NSITF that we are talking about, they submitted the budget of NSITF to him. He single-handedly altered all the budgets, altered the figures. And when the men and women at that agency protested, he threatened to remove them. What did he do? The minister inserted a 2 billion commission project, 2 billion naira worth. He inserted 2 billion for collection, commission on collection, something that has never happened in that agency. In other words, he needed the management and staff of that agency to, the management and the executive committee of that agency to be out of office so that he can implement that budget. What did he do, Mr. Speaker? He removed all the people who were against that decision and left it to the people who never knew about the argument between them. That is one. Mr. Speaker, honorable colleagues, we have ministers, especially this particular minister, he single-handedly nominated the contractor that bought all the vehicles. Wow. Worth 305 million last year in 2019 budget. And these men, the executive members, said this 2020 they will not allow that to happen again. So the moment the budget was approved, 2020 budget, he felt that he would not have control of those things he had inserted in the budget if these people remain there. And the only way to do it is to send them away. That's the crux of the matter. That's the crux of the matter. Mr. Speaker, we are entitled to Camry cars here as our official car. A minister of the Federal Republic will be provided with his convoy of vehicle by the ministry. But Ngige, that is not enough for Ngige. He went ahead and compelled this same presenter of NSITF to buy him an SUV, a Toyota Land Cruiser and a Hilux in 2019. Mr. Speaker, this same minister has inserted 4 SUVs in 2020 budget, which the men and women that he decided to send away refused to say, we will not implement this budget. These are the issues. Mr. Speaker, and it may also interest you, Honorable Colleague, to note that his wife, Dr. Mrs. Ngige, worked in, what do you call it? Civil Service.
Go ahead. So
thank you. He took advantage of the fact that his wife works with the head of service and got approval signed by his wife to the Ministry of Labor to appoint an insurance broker for insurance worth 100 million every year. This approval was issued, signed by his wife on the 6th of May, Mr. Speaker, to him. And he wrote approval immediately to NSITF to accept that broker on the 10th of May. What a speed of light. These are the issues. These are the issues that they want to conceal by sacking these people. Thank you.